Okay. Hello, everybody. This presentation will be in English. I'm sure you all know that it will be in English. Also because, or mainly because, the course I'm going to present is and will be in English, except for those subjects which are delivered in other languages, French, Spanish, German, Russian, and also Italian as a second language. But we will soon see what that is about, because there's a lot to say about our master's course in Language Sciences and Cultural Studies for Special Needs. I will do so by introducing some of the main topics, and then I will let some of my colleagues talk. They won't be here, but I will show you a video clip that you will be able also to watch on our YouTube channel, University of Parma YouTube channel. And then the third part of this introduction, of this presentation, will be free to any questions you may want to ask, all right? So, since we don't have all that much time, we only have half an hour more or less, a few minutes less than that, I will start straight away. And the first thing I'm going to tell you is really a warm welcome to all of you, those of you who are now attending our BA course in foreign languages. Some of you are, I've already recognized some of the faces here, but some others are new faces, to me at least. So welcome, everybody. So you will listen to me, and I'm a professor of educational linguistics at the University of Parma, and the other people who you will listen to are some of my colleagues. Well, the introduction is based on some key issues for our course. Mind you, as I said before, I don't have all that much time, so please refer to our website, which I will show you in a few minutes, and which carries all the information which is needed to find out more about this course. First of all, it's an international course. An international course in the Italian university system means that, as I said before, most subjects are delivered in English. I would say all the subjects except for the second language subjects, all right? So the modules for Spanish literature and Spanish language are, of course, delivered through Spanish and not in English. But all the rest is in English. It's an international course, not only because of that, but because it's full of foreign students. This year's first year group was formed by, let's say, 40% of foreign students, students from Eastern Europe, student from Africa, student from Asia, also Far East Asia, which means that we are in an environment that we can define based on the idea of internationalization at home. This carries a lot of meanings with it. It means that when we speak to a group of students and we're using English, it's not just because it's nice and fashionable, maybe nice, maybe not, but it's fashionable, it's trendy, but it's because half of the class don't or wouldn't understand when I speak Italian, if I spoke Italian during the classes. So it's a real communication need and not something just posh, okay? Snobbish. Nothing of the sort. Not only that, it's also a way for students who, for lots of reasons, are not in a position, for economic reasons, for example, to go abroad, to improve and to grow within an international environment. It means that teachers need to think about the way they teach. They need to think about the way they assess students. Exams have to be different. The ways that you handle your classes, you as a teacher, me, okay, and all my colleagues. So it is an internationalized environment, bringing lots of issues and questions about intercultural communication topics and issues, okay? Great. So language, culture, intercultural communication, as I said, diversity. Of course, it's a very diverse environment. Lots of people from different nationalities, which means that not only as a final aim, but as a way to deal with daily life of the course, we need to build on intercultural relationship. Okay, so these key words are there to illustrate, to picture the way our course works. And then inclusive education. The course is called Language Sciences and Cultural Studies for Special Needs. So the idea is to gear, to direct our focus towards what's needed to make communication available, accessible to everybody in an inclusive way. Of course, we're dealing with people who may want to become teachers in the future. Some of you won't become teachers. They don't think that teaching will be their future. This course is not just for language teachers. It's, for example, for people who want to deal with, as I said before, communication issues in an inclusive way. Let's say, how to access online communication on e-learning platforms. We have a course dedicated to instructional design, for example, which means how to create modules and learning paths online in an inclusive way, which means that students on our course learn day by day how to handle texts, for example, promoting subtitling or audio guides for museums, etc., etc. Okay. It's, of course, a second language degree, sorry, a second level degree in linguistics, which means laurea magistrale, lasting 2 years. And another key feature is the fact that it is delivered, it is a blended course, which means that most of our lessons are video recorded, except for language instruction classes, lettorati, okay, which can't be delivered online, but most of our lessons are recorded and they're left there on our e-learning platform, ELLI, available for all students, which means that also students who can't attend the classes can follow, attend in a distance mode, okay? For a while, for a certain period of time. Of course, exams have to be taken, have to be sit for in presence, so at Parma University. Not only language sciences, but also cultural studies. You will listen to my colleague, Professor Salia, in a moment, talking about that, the cultural aspects. You will listen to my colleague, Professor Beseghi, talking about language issues, and to my colleague, Professor De Luiso, who's the first one on when I leave him the floor, who will speak about inclusive language education. Okay, as far as I am concerned, I still need to do something with you before the question time, which is, of course, at the end of our presentation. This is how the course is structured. As you can see, there are two curricula, so two programs. The first one's there, Italian as a foreign language program. It is aimed to prepare students to become, in this case, teachers of Italian, both abroad, Italian as a foreign language, as a second language, or in Italy, because this type of course allows you to become a teacher of history, geography, Italian in Italian schools. Of course, state schools. Of course, we need some adjustments in the study plan, but it's feasible, it's possible. And so students who want to become both, specialized both in English and in Italian as a foreign language, they can do so by following this program. The second program is Italian, second language program, sorry, which is there. And you can see that you can choose between among langue française, lingua espagnola, deutsche Sprache, and ruski jazyk. Sorry for those who are learning Russian, it's not my cup of tea. So these four languages at the moment. Portuguese will be the next one on, but not for next year, but for the following year, possibly. Okay, great. Core subjects, as you can see up there, we can start straight away from the very beginning of the course, first semester, academic writing, and soft skills for language learning and teaching. So, if you think about it, that means quite a lot, because when you start talking about an internationalized environment, an internationalized course, etc., you need to take into account that most foreign university systems are based on written exams more than on oral exams. We tend to have both written and oral, but we definitely know that we need to boost your writing skills in English. Okay, so academic writing. And then if you look at here, this very last part, there's also a module on research methodology that we consider absolutely fundamental. And soft skills. Soft skill is a concept which is very trendy, and it means a lot. But mainly it means transversal competencies. So the way you can solve problems, the way you can approach things critically, the way you work in groups, the way you, lots of transversal competencies, okay? And it's also very important because, as I said before, we are in a very internationalized environment. You can't deal with foreign students without taking into account their background knowledge, their way of approaching things, etc., etc., etc. So that's at the very beginning. Then we carry on with cognitive linguistics, language learning, teaching and assessment, language education for special needs, neuroscience and language. Neuroscience and language taught by a physiologist, so a neuroscientist, not a linguist, because we think that it is fundamental to understand how our brain works in order to make sure that the results of our, what we operationalize in our brain becomes communication, for example. And this is another core subject. Not taught as if you were medical students. The approach is for the humanities, okay? But still, this is what we have. English language and literature, and then in the second year you have quite a few choices, quite a few courses to choose from. Okay, this is last year's plan, so there have been some changes, but all in all, the course objects are, most of them, available also for next year. It is suitable for part-time students, so if someone who's a working student can decide to take this course to enroll and do it, okay, go through it in 4 years, not in 2 years. Great. Career prospects. Well, all courses are judged from their level of employability. So what will students do once they graduate? Well, inclusive language teachers in traditional and digital education, fine, become teachers, but with some characteristics. If you think of your past experience in schools, you will definitely have had, you must have had foreign students, foreign classmates, and the context, educational context, so diversified in Italian schools, brings about lots of issues which have to be dealt with the right skills, competencies, which traditional courses in foreign languages don't provide. You can also work as a language expert or editor in publishing houses or web companies. In our stakeholder committee, which is compulsory by law in Italy, and it is represented by lots of different working sectors, okay? There are some of the most important publishing houses in Italy and abroad, from Löscher to Oxford University Press, etc. And they're all very curious, and they're waiting for our students to, for example, for internships or what we call tirocini, okay, internships, because it is a kind of profile which is very much needed on the job market today. Not only because of the pandemic period we all lived through, but because it is how things are going and where things are going. So the world is heading towards certain competencies based on, for example, e-learning. Language testers, we have a very strong link to, for example, Società Dante Alighieri. One of my students is now doing her internship working on tests, language tests for Italian as a foreign language, putting into practice her competence as a, as I said, as a person who can manipulate texts and make language tests, certificates, more suitable for everybody, also for people with special needs. And then, of course, NGOs and international agencies. Okay? So this is pretty much what I wanted to tell you. If you want to carry on after that, there are possibilities, PhD in different fields, postgraduate courses to become teachers in the Italian school system, which is the way you become a teacher. And for me, that's enough. But it is enough just because I want other people to tell you something. So this is from our course, okay? If you surf on Google and you just search for language sciences and cultural studies for special needs, University of Parma, you get it straight away. And you can also watch this presentation again if you think it's useful for you to make a decision.
Inclusive language education is one of the key areas of this degree program. There are a number of reasons for this choice. From a theoretical point of view, we acknowledge that language permeates our lives, activities, and relationships. This is true even in educational context, where language is not just a subject like English or Spanish or Italian as a foreign language, but also a medium through which we learn other subjects. As the linguist Michael Halliday once said, all education takes place through the medium of language. So, language is a key competence for learners to succeed at school and in life. And this leads us to some practical implications that are relevant for our program. First, teachers should become experts in language education. And this means not only teaching the specific languages of a school curriculum, but also promoting the development of communicative, cognitive, social, and emotional competencies. Indeed, we know for a fact that these competencies play a key role in language learning and educational learning as a whole. Second, we need to keep in mind that language learning is a challenging process for students with special needs. This is particularly true when these learners have communication or language disorders or a sensory disability. As a consequence, language teachers should also develop professional skills in the areas of inclusive education. So, this degree offers a number of modules related to different branches of language sciences that are relevant for teacher professional development. In particular, thanks to neuroscience and language and cognitive linguistics, you will get an understanding of the complex relationships between language, mind, brain, and experience, and the implications for learning and teaching practice. Educational linguistics, too, play a key role in our program. For example, you will take two important modules entitled Language Learning, Teaching and Assessment and Language Education for Special Needs. These modules will help you develop the competencies necessary for becoming an expert in inclusive language education. And there are also a number of elective modules which you can choose to further develop your competence in these areas, such as sign language linguistics or instructional design. I would like to add a final remark that I hope will help you appreciate the spirit of this program. In our view, inclusion is not just about special needs. Of course, you will develop specialized competencies on how to teach languages to learners with disorders or disabilities. However, we will also focus on how to make teaching accessible to all students and how to take into account key variables in language learning, such as culture, learning styles, or emotional competence. The assumption behind this degree is that diversity is to be highly valued in language classrooms. We believe there is a need for well-prepared teachers who are willing to take up the challenge of promoting diversity and inclusion in language classrooms. So, are you ready to join this enterprise? Well, it is time for me to leave the floor to my colleague, Professor Nicole Bezzeghi, who will introduce you to the language courses of our program. Thank you for your attention. Bye.
Okay. It's a pity not to listen to Professor Bezzeghi, but I've just realized that we're running out of time, and I'm afraid that we might be kicked out of the classroom. And I don't want to waste your chances to ask us questions, ask me questions in this case. If you want to know anything, if you're interested in finding out something more about the program, please go ahead. You can ask me in Italian and I will answer you in English, no problem. Yes, please.
Ci sono dei prerequisiti.
In terms of which languages you've studied, for example, yes. Are you studying or have you studied foreign languages at university? So, students who have a BA degree in foreign languages are accepted directly to the program, whether they have done mediazione linguistica or civiltà e lingue straniere, okay? Whatever they're called, L11 or L12, the class of the BA course, they are accepted directly on the course if they've done at least, if they've acquired at least 18 credits in English, okay? Since 18, you should have about 30, so it's not much of a problem. That's because students who have graduated in English, they should have a C1 level. That's by law, all right? Whether it's true or not, it's not much of an issue because we have to accept students on the course if they have a degree in foreign languages. Other degrees have to be filtered, have to be analyzed, and a way to analyze your profile is by checking if you have a certificate in English at a B2 plus C1 level, but two specific certificates are accepted, IELTS or TOEFL, okay? So all this is explained on our website, okay? And of course, it's the second language as well. So if you've done Dutch, I'm afraid you can join the program, Dutch or Arabic as a second language, only if you choose the Italian as a second language program, because the only languages that we offer are Spanish, German, Russian, and French, okay? So you need to have a degree in that. Sì, okay, ancora, due rapi. Okay, I'm outside if you want to talk to me. I'm sorry, but we've run out of time. Thank you for joining the presentation. Of course, we need more time, but you can write to me. You can find my email on the website. Thank you.